Hi, this presentation is going to compare the cohort versus the period life table, which are two different kind of life tables used in the field of demography. And the major difference between a cohort table and a period table is that a cohort table is diachronic or longitudinal, depending on which kind of terminology you like, but essentially there's time incorporated into the cohort table. The period table is a snapshot, a single point in time, looking at different groups of people. Now, when we look at a cohort table, it may look similar, but it's actually the same group of people moving through the different age categories on the table. So it's a more dynamic type of table, giving you a longitudinal understanding of a population, as opposed to the static population assumptions embedded in a period table. Another nice thing about cohort tables is that the column on life expectancy actually becomes the actual number of remaining years for that particular population. So this is an example of a cohort table. Again, that means that we're looking at a single population of people, all the way from the first year of life down through the end, which trails off around the age 99, as the table shows. But when you look across the columns, you see the same familiarity, the same columns as we had in the period table. But in the period table, these would represent different individuals, whereas in the cohort table, these are the same individuals over time. But the columns, the number in the population, the number of deaths, the probability of dying, and so forth, down to the average number of remaining years. This is a literal interpretation. So for this particular population, when the members of the population were age 1 to 4, the average number of years remaining for the people in that group of 1 to 4 year olds was 61.8. Now you notice it jumps up to 64.3. That doesn't mean that somehow there's a miscalculation or people somehow gained years in life or something like that. What that means is a lot of the children who died out, who are bringing the average down in the first two rows here, are gone. And actually, you see from the 5 to 9 year olds, it starts to trail off again, right, until the end. Another useful tool when thinking about the cohort versus the period life table is what's called the Alexis Diagram, where we see trajectories of individuals or cohorts through time. So it's sort of a mixture of period and cohort. So this is the time frame, and this is the age group within the time frame, and these are the individual or group trajectories. It's a more visual representation than a table.